The All Progressive Congress APC has offered former President Goodluck Jonathan a chance to run for office on its platform should he defect to the party. It said the former president will be given an opportunity to contest for the 2023 presidency if he joins the ruling party. Now, this was said by the National Secretary of the APC Ketika and Extraordinary Convention Planning Committee, John Akpan Udoyidege. He said this when he was asked about the speculations that Jonathan is considering to join the ruling party. The APC official also said the ex-president will be granted a founding member status if he joins. He, however, added that the opportunity will be given to former President Goodluck Jonathan. It would not be automatic, noting that he would have to compete with other members of the party before getting the ticket. Well, joining us to discuss this is Francis Chilaka. He is a political analyst, and of course, still staying with us in the studio is Babasola Adegbuyi. Gentlemen, thank you very much. Thank you for staying with us. Thank you, Francis, for joining us. Yeah, so I'm going to start with you, Francis. We've heard feelers, and these are unconfirmed reports. And by the way, I'd like to just put it there that the spokesperson of former President Goodluck Jonathan has come out to say that the president hasn't moved to any party, and if he does, that it would be communicated properly. But then we've seen many people moving to the APC as we speak. Femi Fani-Kayode has just joined the APC. After he had said, I mean, I still remember that particular one where he said he would rather die than join the APC, but he's alive, he's in the APC, I'd like to let you know. And as we speak, there are, I think, a senator, if I'm not mistaken, or a member of the National Assembly in River State has recently dumped the PDP, as at today, and joined the APC. And the list is endless. We've seen so many cross-capiting from the PDP to the APC. What's with this story of Mr. President or former President Jonathan joining the APC? What change would he make? I mean, it's not that the APC has a different ideology compared to that of the PDP, is it?
I think the whole thing is that suddenly we're faced in a country where we no longer have men and women of proven integrity. Everybody's thinking of what they want to eat and what they want to drink. So I think that's where the whole problem lies. It will be shameful and sad if former President Goodluck Jonathan decides to join the APC out. I won't be surprised, so to say, but it will be very, very sad and shameful of him to do that. Because if you go back and try to read through all the comments, all the abuses hurled at him by members of APC, that are now asking him to come and join them, and you ask yourself, are politicians suffering from dementia or something? Is there something that we're not aware of as people that the politicians are aware of? You know, because it's for me, it is completely laughable, it is completely unacceptable, and does not hold water in a civilized society that we all belong to.
I'm confused as to why you're sad, or why you're saying you will be sad, or why you're saying that it would be very embarrassing. The members of the APC, most of them, were members of the PDP. So, again, what is the fuss if a former president of this country, who used to be in the People's Democratic Party, decides to join the APC? Being that the APC seems to be, I mean, all the political parties are facing, they're having their fair share of, you know, internal party crisis. But for the PDP, it seems to be most obvious because the headship or the leadership of the party seems to, you know, be shaking. And so we see a lot more people. We saw members of the ruling council in the party move to the APC. Why the fuss? If former President Goodluck Jonathan goes to the APC, will it help the APC to win elections in 2023? Will it change, you know, the hopes of the people of Nigeria? What exactly is it? Is it just because he's a former president and he was on the opposite side when the APC, you know, was trying to get power? Why are we so sad or feel disappointed if this even happens?
Is there anything new that you think good luck will bring to the Nigerian society? Because, I mean, his government was demonized by the same carcass of APC that are now asking him to come back. So I don't understand, why are we so fixated about APC? Everybody is jumping into APC. as if we're running a one-party state. See, it's not about the party. It's more about the selfish interest of individuals, people without ideology. And that is what's playing out. You know, people are not, those we call political leaders or politicians, so to say, are not particular about the well-being of Nigerians. They're not thinking about the welfare of the ordinary Nigerians. It's about what they will get, how much of the national cake they will get for themselves and their cronies. So whenever anybody jumps party, I just laugh, because all it means is that they have no integrity, they have no ideology, they have no self-worth. So it's all about how much am I going to make out of the system? How much am I going to milk out of the Nigerian people? And it is high time that the Nigerian people will wake up from their sleep and realize that these politicians have nothing good for them. We must begin to think out of the box and begin to think of voting people, not based on party affiliations, but based on individuals, what they are bringing to the table, and what they have been able to do for the Nigerian people.
Babasola, just picking up from where he stopped, good governance should be the core of our conversations. This should be a front burner issue. And the country is faced, like I said, riddled with a lot of issues that need to be addressed. But then our headlines, the major headlines on our national dailies, is about who's moving to this party and who's, and we're here on this show, unfortunately, speculating if a former president is going to move from party A to party B. And not, it's not that it's a Republican party and let's say a Labour party. It's the same group of people, just changing party logos. Are we also not the creators of the problems that we're facing in the country if we are letting these same politicians set the agenda?
Well, every politician has every right to move to any political party they desire. But however, it shows the lack of ideology individual has and not the political party. So far, so good. I have no issue with APC as a political party. I have no issue with PDP as a political party. The issue I have with the two of them is just the people in those political parties. Because the people in those political parties has a different ideology, totally different from that of political party, and which has, in one way or the other, overridden what the political party has as an ideology or objectives or goal. So if we are to go by the objectives of these political parties, we will discover that a lot of things would have changed in this country for better. But the people in those political parties are actually using their own personal interest. They are actually using their own personal interest to kill the interest of the political party. Now, if anybody leaves A to P, to B in this country as of today, it's as a matter of self-interest. What he or she is going to benefit from that party is moving to. For Jonathan, he's not there yet. It has not been confirmed that he's in PDP. But the truth is, I will not be surprised. I will not be disappointed if he moves, because that is the way, that's the way we have seen our leaders leading our country. They believe that as long as you are still existing, you still need to be influential, you still need to have benefit, you still need to have control. So they rather move to where they can have all those three than for them to be where they will be irrelevant.
But then we watch these things. You and I, we're Nigerians, we're voting, we're part of the voting populace. We're here. We know these things. We're talking now. The public is listening. But we feel these happenings. We feel these movements. There are people who are diehard followers of the former president. There's people who are diehard followers of all of these politicians. And so we seem to be aiding and abetting these movements, and we applaud them. But then the major issues that we need to be addressed are never addressed. So I rephrase my question again. Are we not part of the problem?
Well, we are part of the problem. And the reasons why we are part of the problem is, number one, we vote by the person. We vote for the person. Most especially those who have popularity, those who have money to spend. and those who sent to us dummy manifestos. We are not interested in those who have the experience on how to turn wealth. We are not interested in those who have that ideology that can make things better. We are not interested in those who can do things in the way we actually want. We are only interested in those who have the money to spend. And that is why we are where we are today.
You just touched on something. I was listening to Professor Mulumba, if I'm not, I think he's a Kenyan activist and lawyer. And I listened to a voice note of his. He was saying that the average African is no longer interested in you waxing, lyrical when you're trying to tell them what you want to change and what you want to do. They listen to you very carefully, and then at the end of the day, they say, well, we've heard you, but we're hungry. So all this English you are speaking, if you do not give us money, it makes no sense. So Francis, how do we change this narrative? Because like I said, our newspapers, the stories that are feeling our news bars are basically those stories that are made by politicians. And so the interest of the average Nigerian is lost in all of this conversation. And we're supposed to be the ones setting the tone for the conversation. It should be the government of the people, by the people, for the people. But then it seems to be the other way around. The government of the politicians, by the politicians, for the politicians. So how do we change that narrative? How do we stop the hunger politics and begin to push for a government that is people-minded and people-oriented?
Well, let me start by saying that what is playing out in Nigeria is not poverty of the mind and not poverty of the stomach, as people want us to believe. Unfortunately, those who call themselves politicians, Nigeria is a country where the politicians have become professional. It has become a professional job to be a politician. And because of that, they throw in everything into it. And as usual, they have programs that do not uplift the people. So the people are improvised, the people are hungry, and then during the election period, what do? They bring out little of what they have stolen from the people and give back to the people as, you know, that. But you see, the thing is, we need to have proper voters' education. This is the time INEC, the National Orientation Agency, the Ministry of Information, all the CSOs around should start educating the Nigerian people.
But those are government
especially
agencies, apart
the
from
people
INEC, apart
in
from,
the rural
apart
areas.
From INEC, sorry, Francis, apart from INEC, these other government agencies you're calling, they don't come alive until when it's almost the eve of, you know, elections. So
that's what I'm saying.
So how are they supposed to rise up if they do not have the wherewithal, if they're not given the mandates, if they're not given the monies? The NOA cannot function inside their office. To do some form of orientation, they need to be given some monies to be able to do that.
Are you saying for them? Are you saying that they are not being given money?
Well,
so
I mean,
those who work in these establishments receive salary. Two, this establishment.
What was the last?
Okay,
let me put it to you. When was the last time you turned on TV, your television, or listened to the radio, and you heard an advertorial, or let's say an announcement by the NOA in the past few, aside from the 2015 and the 2019 elections? When was the last time you heard?
So we're coming to this. I'm saying the same thing with you. But the point is that we seem to have a system that is operating under one man. The system runs under the executive. We have the judiciary, that one on their own, their whole problem is there. We have the legislators that we don't even know what they are doing. They don't know what they're doing. These are things that the legislators should be able to do. But they themselves too, they're all carried away by the largesse of the office they hold. We need to make governance uninteresting. We need to reduce the salaries of those in government. When you do that, you will find out that a lot of people will not be there to do it.
Francis, this sounds really great.
I'm coming.
Who is supposed to reduce the salaries of these politicians?
It's the same politicians.
It's the National Assembly. Who's saddled with that responsibility?
So, pushing the buck away from the reality. The reality on ground is that we need, as a matter of urgency, to have a working electoral process. We need it urgently. The youths of this country need to begin to realize that power belongs to them. And it is time they would take the power from those who are holding them hostage.
How do they take this power?
Our political leaders are holding this country hostage for personal and greedy gains. And we need to stop. People need to stop voting people just because of what they give to them. People need to start voting people who are ready to work, who are ready to deliver to them. Until we face this reality as a people, this country will never move forward.
Okay. Well, Francis Chilaka is a political analyst, and so is Babasola Adegbe. Thank you very much, gentlemen, for being part of the conversation. We're really hoping that something will change. Well, thank you all for being part of this conversation. And even those of you who've been watching, we will be back tomorrow with a fresh conversation on Plus Politics. I am Mary Anna Cohn. Do have a good evening.